Please welcome Senior Executive Director, Christina Smallwood.
My topic was going to be how to sell. I knew what I wanted to share, and so I sent off like my first little key words off to Jensen, our RSD, and she's like, yeah, shout out to Jensen. I sent it off, and she said, are you, whoa, so you're okay with sharing your secret sauce? And I said, you're damn right I am. This is my Monet family. So I hope that you guys are as excited as I am to for this whole little thing. So first off, how many of you know people who like you that won't buy Monet from you? Okay? How many of you have made the mistake of word vomiting all over people? How many of you cannot confidently close a sale? And how many of you have a fear of being salesy? Right? You could say it's okay. You don't want to be salesy. You don't want to be that girl, right? I've been in all of those shoes, trust me. And what I have found is that building and establishing trust is key. And what do we know about trust? It's earned. Which means you gotta work for it, okay? So you may be saying, well, I wanna do that, but I don't know how. I'm gonna help you guys. This training is broken down into two parts. One is a rhythm, the other is a system, okay? So let's talk about the rhythm first. Input and output. What is input? It's your intel, okay? This is using the products. All of them, hair, skin, wellness, pet, our new damage repair. Yes! You gotta smell it, you gotta feel it, and you gotta know it, okay? The idea is to gain an extensive knowledge of experiences. And if you can't use it, let's say you don't have a dog, or the products don't apply to you, find someone that has a dog and use pet, or talk to others about their experiences. If you don't have trouble sleeping, find someone who does, that loves our sleep drops. Talk to them. Talking to others about our experiences will help you learn how to identify what I call key indicators, okay? Frizzy hair, dry skin, damaged skin, trouble sleeping. The more you get acquainted with all of the products, you're gonna learn that there's all these common reasons why people use what they use and why they love what they love about each Monet product. Did you know that you can find these amazing product info sheets on all of our products in our back office? Check this one out, okay? Rejuvenique. It lists benefits, ingredients, who it's ideal for, and some of the newer info sheets. I was just back there screenshotting them. Those are gold, you guys. They showcase our clinical results. How rad is that? Okay, incredible value. Especially as they launch new products. These are my go-to for outputting all I can into my brain, or inputting into my brain, about Monet products. So the goal is to have a mental filing cabinet in your head, like a little cabinet of stories and examples about each product, okay? And then you can know all the knowledge that'll be key in helping you establish trust, okay? Because you want your customers to know how much you care, right? Because we care about our customers. And you want them to know that you're experienced and trust you. So what do you do with your mind files? You share them, okay? Output means sharing. How many of you have said, I'm a shares person? Nobody? Nobody shares in here? Okay. Yeah. Sharing is definitely an important part of the rhythm, If you're not talking about all of this goodness, it could be why you're not having success. So let's talk about some great ways to share, okay? You can showcase before and afters. Testimonials help potential customers understand that there are products that Monade offers that suit their specific needs. While your personal results might be amazing, a potential customer might not relate to it, so they're not even going to express interest to you. Make sure you always share from a wide variety and across all Monade categories as diversely as you can. Demos and tutorials are another great way to share, okay? So when you excitedly exude all of your passion about the products, a consumer will decide that they want to purchase from you. When you're demonstrating it, it's educating them. So like, let's take a moment to explain something like our Renew shampoo, okay, right? Or any of our shampoos, really. You get the hair really wet, put it in your palm, emulsify in your palm, then apply. The first wash isn't going to do anything. Then the second wash, you're going to get a lather, right? You're explaining it. Every single one of you should have a reel or an IGTV that says all this, or a post. Because when you educate people, and they understand, educated people are the ones that make decisions to purchase. Talk about simplifying. You're showing them and walking them through why it's different. Customer testimonials. I never let a customer send me a text like, I had the best hair day, or I was scared to use it, and now I love it, without sharing it on social media, you guys. This is third-party validation from an actual customer of yours, and it is gold, okay? And it helps other people feel like, oh, okay, if Sally tried it, I guess I can too, right? So getting in a groove of this rhythm will get a lot of action started for you guys. So that's the rhythm, okay? Now let's talk about the system. How many of you guys have been to a Starbucks? How many of you have been to a Starbucks today? Okay, you got in line or you ordered it. Okay, they have a great system. You don't just pull up and start calling the shots, right? No, you pull up and then you roll down your window. What do they usually say? Thank you for choosing Starbucks today. Can we get you started with a breakfast item? And then you gotta decide, like, do I want a bacon Gouda breakfast sandwich today? Do you have any, right? Then you order. Then you pull forward, they tell you the price, you pay, you get your Starbucks, and you go. It's a system, okay? I've broken down my version of this system into three C's. Curiosity, connect, and cart. So salesy talks, selling listens, okay? In the beginning of my business, it was really bad. I just freaking answered any question that anyone would ask me at any time. And if they said, well, I'm interested in that Rejuvenique oil, can you tell me a little bit about it? I just had a copy paste, threw it at them and told them it retails for $99, VIP is $84, and if you're a market partner, you get it for $69, right? And so I told them everything I knew about it that they could easily Google. That's not building trust. That's not listening. That's not establishing a relationship. It's not my job to tell them everything I know. When someone asks you about a Monade product, this is your opportunity to listen to why they need our product. So if someone asks me about the oil now, I view that as them coming into my drive-thru. Like, thank you for choosing Christina today. Can we get you started with a skincare system? Not really, but I do greet them and I thank them. And I say, I would love to help you. Is it okay if I ask you a little bit about you to see what we can customize specifically from Monade for you? I get curious about them. People love filling out questionnaires of themselves, you guys. You all know you do. You all know what Disney princess you are on Facebook, okay? Any other Mulans out there? Any? Yeah? People love it. So if you ask them, they will absolutely oblige. So notice here in my curiosity, I like to use voice too, but I wrote it out because just, you know, for the sake of this, but I love that Lola mentioned that earlier. Notice here, I'm giving them exactly what I'm looking for, literally the exact words that I'm looking for. Frizzy, flat, dry, curly, etc. And I even throw in a fun random Starbucks question because it adds a fun little element to the conversation. And now we're talking, I'm like, oh, you get a dirty chai too? Or, oh my gosh, I've never tried that drink. And now here we are connecting and talking about something new. And she asked me, probably just like randomly what the oil did. Okay, so I'm not gonna ask just about what they're coming to me for, right? Just like when you go to Starbucks and they don't roll on the window and go, hey, okay, so like, what are you here for, right? They offer me a breakfast item. So, and this is what we do. Since we just talked about your hair, let me just ask you about your skin and if you're using supplements already. It's really simple, you guys. We just ask them questions. It's literally your job to sell them Monate. So you have to be curious. Ooh, geez. Yikes, I'm parched. Okay. You have to be curious for all categories. The next C is connect. And I really, really, really want to stress this one because it's very important. After you get the list of all their responses, your only job is to match their problems to our products. That's it. And as you're working on your input and your output, this part gets easier and easier. You've got those stories in the back of your head, okay? You will make all recommendations for hair, skin, and wellness. Let them know all the products that you believe will be best for them based on all of your experience. Use all those mind files, pull examples from, and feel free to use tools the company provides for us. Amazing company that provides these amazing tools for us. Check out my conversation here, okay? I'm like, you sound just like me. And then I share my progress picture. Right here, here in the conversation, is where you get to build trust and connect with them and show them all you know. They've already come to you looking for the answer. So you get to build trust by sharing stories and examples. Let them know that if they get a shampoo and conditioner, they're definitely gonna want a leave-in and a mask. And if they just think they want a facial cleanser, they're definitely gonna wanna use our essence and a moisturizer and our rewind for the best results. You guys are the ones who knows our products. You know how they work, and you gotta use this time to educate them on why they'll want a complete system. That way, if they go against you, you'll say, I did recommend that product for you. You know, you might wanna screenshot it, you might not wanna screenshot it, right? But you'll say, it's okay, we're gonna get you set up. And then you're gonna wanna integrate also why they're gonna want wellness now to support beauty from within. Okay? Now, the most scariest C of all, carts. Never, I repeat, never get someone to this part of your system and know all the products that you recommend and why, and then just like let them go and be like, well, I put the ball in their court now, so they're gonna let me know what they want. No! They kinda gotta feel like they're right there at the checkout with you. You can walk over prices with them. Say, okay, well, if we add the wellness, this is what it is. If we take off the wellness, this is what it is. I give my customers like a full cart experience. And I use this as an opportunity to explain Purchase Plus. Okay, well, if we add a few more, then we're gonna get this discount. And if you are doing those things like outputting, they're already gonna have a good idea of how it works. I do give the retail cost, and then I also give a VIP cost. And as you can see, I think one of my conversations is coming up. But as you can see, you can discuss all the incredible perks, different things, and just kind of assume that sale, like Lola said. So you already know their problems. They already have told you, and now you've recommended products based on that, okay? Our president, Stuart McMillan, once said, and I'll never forget it, he said, when the promise is clear, the price is easy. I'll say it one more time. When the promise is clear, the price is easy. And I will never forget it because it's just so true, and it's why asking them for their problems up front before you talk about anything else is key. I like to under-promise and over-deliver when it comes to VIP price, so I'll say something really quick like, oh, you know what, okay, I think off the top of my head, you know what, before I build the carts for you, I think it's gonna be this much just so you know what to expect, but I'll go build it. I'm gonna bring you back some screenshots and we'll talk about what we can get, you know, situated for you. Then I come back to them, I'm like, oh my gosh, Becky, look at, no, I'm just kidding, okay. I couldn't resist. Oh, I get back to them and I give them a deal they can't refuse. Like, oh my gosh, it's actually $15 cheaper if you do it today. This creates urgency, and it's not even a flash sale. It's not even anything. I'm just creating that urgency for today. And then they usually are so excited, so educated, that they say, oh my gosh, okay, let's do it. Or they might say, can we wait till Friday? Is that okay if we wait till Friday? And I'm like, okay, let me check. You know what? Yeah, we can wait till Friday, okay? So I'm just gonna save that cart for you, and then I'm gonna send it. And in the US and Canada, as of right now, you can actually save and send a cart. And I think it's an amazing option to help close a sale for you. So this system of the three C's not only gets them excited about their current order, it gets them super excited about all their future orders. Because you've already mapped it all out. You've already explained it all. They already know why they want it. And half the time, they move their flagship up because they're so excited. This system is what I use. This system is what I teach. I didn't win one VIP Monty award until I began using this system as a director, okay? And so I'm just gonna leave you guys with this. Zig Ziglar said it best. If people like you, they will listen to you. But if they trust you, they will buy from you. Okay, you guys? Now, who's ready to utilize this rhythm and this system and go out there and sell some money? Yes, I love it. And I want you guys to tag me when you have success or send me a DM and let me know because I can't wait to celebrate with you. Thank you so much. I know it's lunchtime and you guys are aching to go. Thank you so much, you guys. I love you.
All right, Monate family.